one, two, three, four, and five. We got a 10.
Our private thoughts often get lost in the translation of our black sense. We do so much code switching on the back end, we start to sound like computers. They need tutors to understand us. Hood girls, stand up. We stretch from Pilsen to Wilson, from Addison to Madison, from Blackstone to Calumet, from Langley to Lafayette. That's about as Chicago as you can get. I hope now there's no confusion. If you know, you know.
Right.
I'm talking to them girls from the low end who go into the shop every other week to get their eyebrows on fleek. To them, we speak Ebonics, but it's all just simple phonics, and you simply don't know the patterns of our dialect.
Right.
We tolerate no disrespect. No matter where your gender falls on the spectrum, a city girl gon' correct them. So come correct when you speak to us. The white folks want to be meek with us. Right. Talking about they understand our upbringings. So you know about Cabrini Green, Ida B. Wells? Mm-hmm. Tell me what you know about the PJs that they tore down to make E-Ways. You can't even comprehend what I just said. All the books you've read don't compare to this. Read my lips. It's nothing like the real thing. Nothing like juke sliding on a Saturday at the Fifi or like seeing Jesse White tumblers on the TV at the Bud. Nothing like the blood rushing through your veins as you try to catch the train because the next one don't come for 15. Nothing like filling out at 15 and nasty men making note of it. I wrote of it a few times before, but girls in the hood don't get to be girls.
Right.
We grown before we even turn 18, and it's considered our fault that they act like fiends when we wear skirts or the low crop cut shirts.
Come on.
What happened to creative expression? Why am I to blame for that man's aggression and transgressive attraction to minors? But people put on their blinders when you look a certain way.
Yep.
I'm a black woman every day, but maybe you just don't see it that way. And they make excuses like you're black first. Tell that verse to the black men harassing me, and don't start hassling me about how black men are targets when some treat us like target practice. The simple fact is, patriarchy obstructs some black men's view of how to treat a woman, and that's just the sad truth. I remember fighting tooth and nail with a whole paper trail, and everyone told me to drop the charges against a black man. Even my black friends told me I was tripping. What about all the missing women? Or the fact that my classmate was kidnapped and killed. You'll say that feminists aren't healed, but who's supposed to do the healing when y'all are killing the woman's population? Femicide is real, and it's a devastation that Chicago girls are facing day to day. Really, it's nationwide, but y'all hide behind lies about misandry to cauldron misunderstandings. And I'm not handing any trophies to the so-called good guys because they hurt us too. This piece was meant to celebrate girls in the hood, but it turned to so much more. It's like we're fighting a war with no protection. Upon further inspection, our so-called protection is the one fighting us in the battle. But it sits at an impasse. I was broken by my last few encounters, and there's not enough love to heal a damaged heart. I missed the part when it was easy. We were just friends testing the waters. Now I'm thinking of daughters, sons, responsibilities ain't no fun. Some days I want to run, other days I want to stay under you until the sun sets. This is as close to perfect as it gets. You know, I'm a perfectionist by way of upbringing, but I don't hear alarms ringing. You help me control my tendency to always want to be right. You make my midnights bright. You are my guiding light, because sometimes tunnel vision gets so bad, and I only see my dad or the bad men who mirrored that pain. You help me stand the rain when it's running against my window. You hold my hair as the wind blows in, scares and tears from my past life. You are like a flashlight. A reliable source of trusted energy, you brought out the artist in me, took my pen out of retirement. You are so inspiring. You make the best fit. This is a about as close to perfect as it gets. But it's not always roses. Sometimes they will. We'll be in a good mood, then the mood is killed because I have a burst of emotions and I have a devotion to making everything fit this schema. I've always been a dreamer, thinking of wedding dresses and silk presses, but the stress is, I don't think you're there too. I want to wear two beautiful gowns and go out of town and build our own tiny town of toddlers. I want to fall in love with you as a father, and I sometimes wonder why I even bother, because it just feels so far away for you. I want you to feel this too, but I can't make you ready. And I hate that we never went steady, just straight into commitment. I hate feeling like I'm missing my 20s for a hopeless fairy tale. I hate feeling like I told my daughter to trust her gut. Sometimes I think I'm not perfect enough. I'm not in good shape and I don't take my hygiene seriously, and who'd want to marry that? And if you marry fat, your kids might inherit that. I get insecure sometimes too. But the truth is, I love you and I want this to be our life. I want all of you and nothing less. But I fear this is as close to perfect as it gets.
Oh, poet.
It's the closest to perfect I think I'll get. But it sits at an impasse. I was broken by my last few encounters, and there's not enough love to heal a damaged heart. I missed the part when it was easy. We were just friends testing the waters. Now I'm thinking of daughters, sons, responsibilities ain't no fun. Some days I want to run, other days I want to stay under you until the sun sets. This is as close to perfect as it gets. You know, I'm a perfectionist by way of upbringing, but I don't hear alarms ringing. You help me control my tendency to always want to be right. You make my midnights bright. You are my guiding light, because sometimes tunnel vision gets so bad and I only see my dad or the bad men who mirrored that pain. You help me stand the rain when it's running against my window. You hold my hair as the wind blows in, scares and tears from my past life. You are like a flashlight, a reliable source of trusted energy. You brought out the artist in me, took my pen out of retirement. You are so inspiring. You make the best fit. This is about as close to perfect as it gets. But it's not always roses. Sometimes they will. We'll be in a good mood, then the mood is killed because I have a burst of emotions and I have a devotion to making everything fit this schema. I've always been a dreamer, thinking of wedding dresses and silk presses, but the stress is, I don't think you're there too. I want to wear two beautiful gowns and go out of town and build our own tiny town of toddlers. I want to fall in love with you as a father, and I sometimes wonder why I even bother, because it just feels so far away for you. I want you to feel this too, but I can't make you ready. And I hate that we never went steady, just straight into commitment. I hate feeling like I'm missing my 20s for a hopeless fairy tale. I hate feeling like I told my daughter to trust her gut. Sometimes I think I'm not perfect enough. I'm not in good shape and I don't take my hygiene seriously, and who'd want to marry that? And if you marry fat, your kids might inherit that. I get insecure sometimes too. But the truth is, I love you and I want this to be our life. I want all of you and nothing less. But I fear this is as close to perfect as it gets.
That's Spirit of the Martian, y'all. Judges. So, it's up. We got one, two, three, four, and five with a 9.0, a 9.5, a 9.6, a 9.7, 9.8.